Good morning, students. Welcome back. Today we shall discuss some diseases caused by different types of organisms. Okay. Already we have completed the chapter. Now in this series we will discuss about different types of diseases which are spread through different kind of organisms. Today we will discuss the disease which is spread by worms. So today we will discuss about filariasis, or it is, which is also called elephantiasis. Now let us see what it is. The pathogen which causes filaria or elephantiasis, that is also called filarial worm, that belongs to helminthus group. And here, what is the name? What is the scientific name? That is Bucheria bancrofti. That is the scientific name of this filarial worm that causes filariasis or elephantiasis. Now let us see the mode of transmission. How it is transmitted? It is transmitted through the bite of the mosquitoes. It can be Aedes or Culex. Clear? Now next we have the symptoms. What are the symptoms of this diseases? So symptoms, main symptom is the fever. First symptom is fever. Then you have swelling in certain parts of the body like legs, breast, scrotum, etc. So this swelling is there. What is the reason for the swelling? That is because of the collection of the endothelial cells. Because of the collection of the endothelial cells and metabolites in the wall of the lymph vessels. Because of the collection of this endothelial cells and metabolites in the lymph vessels, there is a swelling in some definite parts of the body. Mainly it occurs in the legs. So when there is swelling in the leg, that is called elephantiasis. Why the name is given? Because when the swelling is there in the leg, one of the leg, it looks like the leg of the elephant. So from here the name comes elephantiasis. Now let us see the prevention. So as it is caused due to the mosquitoes, so first thing is that we have to prevent the entry of the mosquitoes in our house where we are living. So what we have to do? We have to use mesh doors. Door where, which has the nets, windows which have the mosquito nets, so that it does not allow the mosquitoes to enter. So we have to put nets in the doors and windows so that the mosquitoes does not enter our house and does not bite us. Then what we have to do is, somewhere water is collected, there we have to add some kerosene in the ditches. In some ditches where it is filled with water and the water is stagnant, that becomes a breeding place of the mosquitoes. So in the ditches, what you have to do, we have to spray some kerosene, so that when the kerosene is sprayed, the mosquito larva cannot grow, it dies. Okay, then we have to first mesh door and windows in the doors and windows in the house to check the entry of the mosquitoes. Second, sprinkling of kerosene in ditches, okay, which prevents the growth of the mosquitoes. Then water collected in the tanks and other articles. If water is collected in the tank or other articles, that should be covered nicely so that the mosquitoes do not enter and lay their eggs. Because mosquitoes, when they lay egg on the stagnant water, it can breed easily and it can grow into larva. At the rest of the stages, it can attain and it can complete its life cycle. So we have to prevent the growth of the mosquitoes. So various ways, in this way we have to prevent the mosquitoes' growth. Then last, the drug. The medicine that is given to the person who is suffering from filariasis, that is DEC, that is diethyl carbamazine. So this is the medicine that is given to the person who is suffering from filariasis. Thank you. Have a nice day.